I'm Michelle Petnow from Mosaic Made Easy, and today I want to talk about safety. First, now that I have your attention, mosaic art is not dangerous. In 24 years, I've had maybe two minor incidents, but that's because I know what to do when working with all these tools and materials. So let me get out of this and we'll get right to it. Okay, so the first thing I want to address is visitors, pets, children coming into your studio space. So it's really important that whatever you do to protect yourself, that you're going to do for them as well. You want to wear closed shoes all the time. Just have an extra pair of sneakers that you can keep in your studio or something you can slip on that's not open-toed. The absolute most important things to have in your studio, and that's a dust mask and goggles. Now, if you're new to Mosaic, you may not be familiar with the terms grout and thinset, but grout is a mortar-based material that we use to fill in the cracks and crevices, the spaces between our tiles. It is not an adhesive, but it is a cement-based product, and any cement-based product is going to have sand. It's going to create a dust when you mix it, and it may also contain silica. Silica, if you breathe it, and you breathe it over time, I don't think once is a big issue, but we use it a lot. You do not want to breathe that dust. It can cause scarring in your lungs, which could lead to lung cancer. So take that extra effort and wear your mask when you're mixing grout until it gets wet. Thinset is also a cement-based product that we mix with water or an additive. It too is going to have silica in it. And thinset is an adhesive. So those two things, grout and thinset, is probably what we use the most. Now, anytime you're going to wear this, you're definitely going to want to wear goggles as well. And you want the kind that have protection on the side and the top. This is a glass grinder. We use it a lot. Sometimes we use it on ceramic tile, but most often on glass. And it does kick up some dust. Again, you don't want to breathe it. You don't want it in your eyes. In addition, you don't want it in your hair. If it goes all over the place, and that glass dust doesn't look like glass, you're not going to see glass, but they're minute particles of glass, and on your hands you probably wouldn't notice it, but if it gets in your hair and you do this and it gets into your eyes, that could create a problem. So when you're using this glass grinder, this goes around and we use it to take sharp edges off of glass and ceramic and even smalty, you want to be wearing the goggles and the mask. If you're working with a glue that has a warning on it about the vapors or the fumes, you want to wear your mask and you want to make sure you're in a well-ventilated area. Make sure those windows are open. It's important to read your labels on every product. I learned everything I knew in the beginning. There wasn't any internet and I'm self-taught. So I really did read the bag. I really did read the instructions. And if it's too small to see, just pull it up online. Read everything about it. Grout has a very drying effect on your hands. It literally sucks the moisture out of your hands. So I wear just these simple little rubber gloves. I get them at the beauty supply because they come in my size and I have small hands. Before I do that, I also put a lotion on my hands to create a little barrier between the dust, and usually I don't have any problem. But if you happen to notice that your hands are super dry after grouting or using thinset, wash them with vinegar. Vinegar will restore the pH to your hands, and that lack of pH is what causes the drying. I have another pair of gloves that I always use when handling glass. This is a heavy-duty glove, and it's got a heavy rubber front on it. And I have never cut myself on glass when I'm wearing these gloves. The biggest incident I've had with cutting myself in 24 years was walking past a cabinet that I used to store sheet glass, and one piece wasn't pushed all the way into the shelf. So it was over the edge of the shelf, and I walked by and ended up with a gash this big. Now, it wasn't very deep, so it wasn't serious, didn't require a trip to the emergency room, but it sure was messy, which is why I always have rags around to clean up messy stuff, especially spills on the floor. First aid kit, I think that's pretty obvious. You want to just keep Band-Aids and some bandages around. The last thing I want to talk about is the thing that surprised me the most. About 6 months ago, I dropped a brand new paring knife. This has nothing to do with Mosaic, but I dropped it. It hit my shin and made a pretty deep gouge. Yeah, it hurt. It hurt. Made a pretty deep gouge into my shin. I did have to go to the emergency room. And just like every other time I've been to the doctor or the ER, the first thing they said was, "When was your last tetanus shot?" And I said, "I don't know. I couldn't remember how many years." And I go, "Why? The knife was brand new. It wasn't dirty. You know, I always thought you had to be out in the yard and step on a rusty nail or something dirty." And I got an education. The doctor told me that, number one, tetanus can live in dirt and dust for up to 40 years. How come nobody ever told me about that? I didn't even know it lived in the dirt. I thought it came from the rust. Well, I work in the yard a lot, so I really paid attention, because if you do have a deep cut or puncture wound and you have not had a tetanus booster in the last 5 years, they recommend it every 10 years, but if you have a cut like that and you haven't had a booster in the last 5 years, they're probably going to recommend that you get it earlier than later. And so it's a really good reason to make sure that your any little cut or puncture wound is really covered, and you wear gardening gloves before you go out in the yard. That, I was so flabbergasted by that, I just had to share it. And if there's any other question that comes up and you're not sure about a certain tool or saw or anything that is regarding safety, just email me. If I don't know the answer, I'll certainly look it up for you. And again, it's not dangerous. Mosaic is so much fun. We just want to use every precaution to make sure we know what we're working with. And I certainly appreciate you spending the time with me today. And we just want to have a happy, healthy time doing our mosaic art. So go out, have fun, and be safe.